Hey everybody, and welcome to another edition of All Things Universal Orlando. Today, we're going to be looking at the top 5 things I think you should be doing, that you're probably not, when going to Universal Orlando. So before we begin, I want to remind you to like, subscribe, and hit the bell notification so you can be made aware every time we put out a new video. And remember to check us out on Instagram, and now you can also find us on Facebook for exclusive content. Let's get to it. Hey again, everybody. Welcome to another edition. This should be a pretty fun one, probably won't take real long, and we're just going to look at a few things I think that you should be doing that you probably aren't doing when you go to the parks. Now, before you get on to me in the comment section and say, oh, I do that and things like that, listen, everybody's different, and I know some of you are doing these things, and I know that some of you probably aren't. That's not really the point. The point is to present you with some options of things you might not be doing. So let's get right to it.
Great Scott, number five.
If you're like me, Universal Orlando can be expensive, and you like to set aside and save money to have for a nice haul when you go there. I like t-shirts and clothing and things like that, so I set aside a fair amount of money over the course of the year that I know I'm going to spend on merch when I get to the parks. If you're also like me and you have children, children don't think in terms of budgeting, and the things they like tend to be expensive. And so I'm here to tell you about a couple of things that aren't very expensive that kids love, that you can enjoy, and I think you should be doing, taking advantage of when you go to the parks. Number five is pressed pennies. Pressed pennies are inexpensive, fun for the kids, interactive. My daughter is 15, has been collecting them for years, and every day when we're in the hotel before we go to the park, she makes sure that I have quarters and pennies to help her get these things. She has books full of pressed pennies, and she absolutely loves them. They are wonderful memories that you can have for your kids that don't cost you very much. I found a couple of websites that have lists of locations of all the pressed pennies, and I don't know how up to date they are and things like that. You're seeing some of these images on the screen now that have all of the locators where you can find a pressed penny machine at Universal, Islands of Adventure, and also in CityWalk. I can't remember, and I'm not sure if they have them in Volcano Bay, and I don't know that that's a thing, but what I'm getting at is this is a very inexpensive treat, a wonderful thing for your kids to enjoy, or maybe you enjoy, when you go to the parks. Recently, over the past, I don't know, year or two, they've installed some new pressed penny machines in the Harry Potter areas. And you put, I think, $5 in and you get a certain number of them. And they're very nice. They're high quality. The pennies are always shiny and things like that. And it becomes, like I said, a very inexpensive and nice feature for your kid or yourself to enjoy when going to the parks. It's not going to break the bank, and it's fun and interactive. And so for all those reasons, pressed pennies, this is the fifth thing I think you should be doing when going to Universal Parks.
Number four
is pin collecting. Now, I know this is a big Disney thing, and I know that it's a much bigger thing in Disney than it is in Universal with trading options and things like that, pin trading posts and all those kind of things. But Universal has some really nice pins. This is another thing that my daughter actually does save her money for, does budget her money for, and does spend on. She has an exceptional pin collection, and she looks forward to this as much as she does going to the parks. They have some really nice pins available as well. Some of them are more expensive than others, but usually you can find some closeouts and some discounts on multiple pin sets, kind of like a buy two, get two free kind of a situation. And different stores will have these pins set aside in different locations. The Harry Potter pins are exceptional and very collectible. The ride-oriented pins or the attraction-oriented pins and the debut pins, the individual theme park pins, all of these things are fun to collect and, again, not very expensive. Some of them can be pricey. You can pay up to $19, $20 for a pin, But that's probably for the, you know, real strict collector, like my daughter, and she has done that. But generally, she tries to be frugal and get the best bang for her buck when it comes to pins. Universal has plenty of locations for pins. They have kiosks set aside for pins. They have pin locations in every store and all throughout the Harry Potter areas, the Wizarding World, Diagon Alley, and Hogsmeade. You can find multiple sites that have pins that are great for collecting. And again, not very expensive, and a good, cheap, long-lasting memorabilia for your child to enjoy when they visit the theme parks that isn't going to break your bank. So, for all of those reasons, pin collecting is the fourth thing I think you should be doing that you're probably not. Universal Parks.
Top 10 gigawatts, that's number three!
Number three is one of my favorite things to do when we go to Universal Orlando. I don't talk about it much, and it's only recently become a really favorite thing of mine, but I really think you should be playing a round of putt-putt golf at Hollywood Drive-In Golf. Mini golf, putt-putt golf, whatever you want to call it, doesn't matter. Both courses are fun. We played at Hollywood Drive-In Golf this past trip and had a blast. It was one of the highlights of our entire trip. We all enjoyed it every bit as much as any of the attractions. This year we played the haunted side, and we really liked that. It's a fun course. It's not overly expensive. You're seeing some of the rates here. If you want to play one of the courses for 18 holes, 10 and over is $17.99. 3 to 9, $15.99. And they give you a discount, and you can see if you play both courses, 10 over the second time, the second course is $14.99. And then 3 through 9, $12.99. So they lower the price if you play again. And I would say, if you can afford this, if it fits in your budget, set a night or a time in the day aside to do this. You won't regret it. It's a ton of fun. It's great interaction from your family. It's not so oppressive from the crowds and the heat if you go at night and things like that. And it's just a lot of fun. And they have games that you can play in the game. You have trivia that you answer. And when you turn in your trivia card, each member in your party gets a scratch off. And many times those scratch offs are for buy one, get one free games or discounts on shirts and memorabilia and things like that. It's a lot of fun, and they give you incentives to come back. And for all those reasons, Hollywood Drive-In Golf is the third thing I think you should be doing that you're probably not when you go to the parks.
Well, here's number two.
Number two is kind of a no-brainer and kind of a duh moment. Get there at park opening. Get there at rope drop. If you're staying on site, they make this very easy. But even if you're not, get there before the park officially opens. Plan to get there 20 to 30 minutes before so that you're one of the first people into the parks when they open. You will get so much more done, even during a peak busy time, than you will if you wait. I'm telling you, even during summer, if you get there at rope drop, you're going to get a lot done before noon when other people are just coming into the park who've enjoyed sleeping in their hotels and things like that. I'm telling you, this is a big one. This is one that you should be taking advantage of if you're not already. I realize a lot of you already do this. I appreciate that. We always do it when we're there, and you should too. It will maximize your efforts. It will make the concept of having an express pass not nearly as important. And during peak times, express passes can get as high as $300 per person. It's expensive, and so you don't want to be caught in that situation. And we all want you to have a great time at the park. Get there at rope drop. You will not regret this. You will be able to go in when the park is not nearly as crowded and hit as many rides as you possibly can early on to get them out of the way so you won't walk away from that day disappointed. If you do this, you'll get to hit the vast majority of attractions that you like, even on the busiest days, but you have to get there before the park opens. For all of those reasons, getting there early is the second thing I think you should be doing that you may not be doing when you go to the parks. Now, I do have an honorable mention, and this is a good one. It's not necessarily inexpensive, but I don't think it's expensive. I've done reviews on it before, and that is, I personally think you should be taking advantage of My Universal Photos. Some people call it the Photo Pass. Whether you're doing the one-day photo package or the three-day, and if you're staying for multiple days, I recommend the three-day. You get two more days for about $20 more. This is worth doing. Now, during COVID, when you're wearing a mask, some people will allow you to take your mask off for the pictures and some won't. But as COVID starts to diminish and the necessity of masks go away, I really think you should be doing this. We do it, we love it, it makes pictures much easier. You get the ride photos included without having to break the bank each time. You have the app. I don't need to go over the review. If you want more information, watch my review on Maya Universal Photos, and I'll put a link to that in the description below and also a card up here for you now. But watch that video, and it will tell you all you need to know about the Photo Pass, or Maya Universal Photos, as they call it. I think it's worth doing. I don't think a lot of people do it because they look at it and say, I'm not going to use this. You will, and Universal does a great job of making it available in key places, and from what I understand, they're adding more all the time. For all those reasons, my Universal Photos, the Photo Pass, is the honorable mention. Now, before I get to the number one, I want to go over the top five we've covered so far. Number five, pressed pennies. I've already talked about it, not going to go into any more detail with it. Number four, pin trading, for all the reasons I've already explained. Number three, Hollywood Drive-In Golf. Take advantage of this. A lot of fun. You won't be disappointed. A little pricey considering average mini golf courses, but you're at a theme park and this is really cool. Probably the best one you'll play. Do this. Number two, get there early. Get there at Rope Drop. You will not regret this. It affords for you to do so many more things than if you don't. So here it is.
Number one!
The number one thing I think you should be doing that you're probably not before you go to the parks, stay on site. I can't stress this enough. I'm big on resort reviews and they're some of my most watched videos. Staying on site changes everything. If you stay at one of the three premieres, you obviously get Express Pass with your stay. That's of course Portofino, Hard Rock, and Royal Pacific. Yes, it's more expensive, but when you consider the value of the Express Pass, it's really not that crazy. And everybody in your party gets the Express Pass who stays in that resort. That's fantastic. Not to mention the transportation, the water taxis, the buses, you name it. Universal has maximized your stay, your vacation, when you stay on site. But they've even taken it a step further now with the addition in particular of Endless Summer, both dockside and surfside. These are very affordable, even during peak times, they're affordable. But if you go during a non-peak time, we went during September, we were able to book these rooms for $79 a night, $99 on the weekends. That's amazing. You're gonna have a hard time finding off-site resorts for that price. You can, but you're gonna get what you pay for. And if you're like me, you wanna stay in a nice, clean resort, even though you're not spending a lot of time there, you wanna know that you're sleeping in comfort and that you're not dealing with the things you deal with when you don't stay at a nice resort. I don't know how else to say it. But not just in the summer. They've done this with Aventura and Cabana Bay. There are so many amazing options with resorts that Universal has made available to you that can fit any budget. Like I said, you can take a trip to dockside or surfside and have a great time in a wonderfully themed resort, and you can check out any of these reviews that I've already done and see what you think about it. Aventura, one of my favorite resorts, only stayed there once, probably my second favorite resort on property. I absolutely loved the simplicity of it, I loved the design, and I loved the modern technology feel that it presents. Cabana Bay, probably my least favorite of the resorts, but I still like it. Sapphire Falls is the one resort that doesn't make sense to me. It's equally as nice as the premieres, but you don't get Express Pass with it, and so I can spend a little more money and upgrade to Royal Pacific or something like that, and have the Express Pass for the same quality resort. But hey, I get it. It's a beautiful resort, and I like it, but I like the premieres better. And then you all know, everybody knows, Royal Pacific is easily my favorite. Hard Rock and Portofino are exceptional as well. And for all of those reasons, staying on site, not the early park admittance, all of the benefits, buying merch and having it sent to your room, it's just phenomenal, all of the things that come from staying on site. And for all of those reasons, staying on site, that's the number one thing you should be doing that you're probably not when you go to stay at Universal Orlando Resort. Hey guys, remember, like and subscribe, hit the bell icon so you can be made aware every time we put out a new video. Thanks for being a part of this. Thanks for helping us grow the channel. Thanks for participating. Leave your comments on what you think I might have missed. What are some other things that you do that maybe we don't do that you can teach us that we should probably try to do the next time we go. So put those things in the comments. Any suggestions you guys might have for future videos, let us know, and we'll make sure that we try to make them. Hey guys, God bless you. Remember, go bless somebody else today. Go do something amazing for somebody else. Don't expect anything in return. And watch the amazing things that start to happen in your life. God bless you guys. We'll see you when we see you.